private industry that they have, the private client industry that they have, is incredibly robust. It's very well run. It's solid. They have not only incredible professionals with great amount of experience, their entire sort of, I would say, legal infrastructure is based around international clients. So they can seriously service anyone from anywhere, and they do it with ease, but with great respect, you know, for the law and what it stands for. I think that from the offshore jurisdictions, the Bahamas can definitely offer way more than let's say some others. They're, you know, free trade zone and things like that. They are incredibly well prepared for meeting international client needs, not only from, you know, private individuals, but also corporations. Our firm was established first as a advisory business for private clients who are looking to structure their wealth, their worldwide wealth in the right manner, and, you know, talking to them about succession or family governance. So a lot of the connections which we have in the Middle East have come about naturally, you know, organically, in the sense that we've been more responding to problems rather than trying to go and tell people this is what you do and this is how you do it. I think for us, it's very important that we work with people who, you know, they might be very wealthy, they might be very successful, but they have problems that need to be solved. Meaning, you know, whether it's from just purely structuring point of view to actually thinking about what is the next step for our business. So our firm has, as I said, sort of responded to the needs of those people that we represent and that we work with. The Gulf countries, definitely, I mean, they control some incredibly mind-blowing sovereign wealth funds, and they are eager to make sure that their money can buy them the best, can buy them stability, and can buy them, you know, essentially succession from oil. However, I do think that they see that there is a lot more that needs to be done. It's not just, you know, yes, money can buy you a lot, but it's about, you know, how is that, I guess, for me, and the way I interpret it is, it's not just about buying a flashy asset. Is that asset going to produce something that will allow your country to grow? SPG as a firm was established to look after international clients and their worldwide assets, and make sure that they're structured properly and that there is the right sort of, you know, whether you call it a family office or any type of other wealth ownership vehicle. So that was sort of our, like the catalyst to everything. Once we got more exposed to the business side of those families, not just, you know, structuring the wealth, but actually thinking about the succession of the businesses and what happens next, that I personally became extremely passionate about sustainability and making sure that, you know, what are you leaving behind? You know, because to me, it's not about making a lot of money and then becoming philanthropic and then, you know, waving your finger at people and saying, this is how you should do it, and just throwing money at things, because there's so much that money can't actually solve. So I think for me personally, it was about what truly makes me feel alive, you know, what truly makes me feel happy, and what type of, you know, business do I want to be involved in.